Abdul Rahman Al-Sudais is famously known for his beautiful recitation of Holy Quran across the world. Before I start his life journey, I need you all to imagine going through older generation in 20th century, where there were no electricity, no cell phones, no gas, living in a muddy house, where you can find group of friends roaming outside the house. This was the time when Al-Sudais came out of the womb at the year 1960 in Saudi Arabia. Growing up here, he was nothing less than a naughty kid. He used to make fun of others, ruin stuffs, irritate people and so on. At the age of 9, once when his mother was preparing food for the guest that just arrived a while ago, he and his friends took some mud and thrown onto the container of the food. Oh my God, such a terrible kid. Obviously, mother yelled, scolded and cursed him. But the difference is, it wasn't like go to hell or don't come in front of me kind of curse. But instead she said, may Allah make you the Imam of Haram. May Allah make you the Imam of Haram. She cursed in such a way. Every time this naughty kid would do something very annoying, she would repeat the same curse again and again. His mother was a very righteous woman who always guided him. Finally, by the wish of his father, at the age of 12, he completed memorizing Quran. As time passed, slowly he began to become very responsible. At the age of 19, he graduated from Riyadh in scientific institution. And then he moved to Islamic University. At the age of 23, he completed Sharia. But miracle thing happened when he was just 24 years old, who was selected as an imam in the Grand Mosque and delivered his first ever ceremony. And life continued as according to the mother's dua that she made 15 years before. His devotion towards Islam and Quran made him receive Islamic Personality of the Year award at the age of 45. Now he is 60 years old, who is president of two holy mosques. Not only that, he played a major role in helping Muslims in Palestine, Iraq, Somalia and Kashmir. Most of his money are sent it to Palestine and other countries who are in need for their medical and food supports. You may be rich, famous or have a high status in this dunya, but to the angel of death, you are just another name on list. So, what's your story?